and to use this occasion as the start of the unification of Philippine society. Well, I think 32 years down the road, we know what the answer is. For some reason, we were able to coalesce as a people. We were able to unite as a people under a common set of values and a common vision. So much so that we remained divided as we were before that summer. As Boy says, we remain color holder. We're divided by yellow, we're divided by red, we're divided by blue, white, and black. We have black and white back. I commemorate this 32nd anniversary of EDSA, worried about our future, and yet at the same time, hopeful. Hopeful that we can still find our way to a certain point where we can all unite. But there are very, very powerful forces that are preventing us from uniting. And you can see it from the issues that we read in the papers. There are those that want to get the incumbent president out because they want to get back in. There are those that are still after the previous dispensations because wala pang closure sa mga hinanakit, sa mga nangyari noong the 80s during martial law. And in the administrations that followed, and also their own set of issues that remain festering at this point. We are a society that avoids closure. We try to ignore, we try to set aside our problems. That's why we never get to solve them. And because we never get to solve our problems, well, we remain divided. Unity is the call of the hour. It has always been the call of the hour. President Ramos, who was the heart and soul of the People Power Revolution, has always called for unity, solidarity, and people. People thought, politiko yan si Presidente Ramos, slogan lang yan, empty words yan. And yet, he defined his presidency with three sets of slogans, but with very deep meaning. The first, unity, solidarity, and teamwork. We cannot be a nation unless we are united, unless we are in solidarity with certain values, and unless we work as a team, we can never achieve our goals. So unity, solidarity, teamwork. The other set is care, share, and dare. Sometimes he pulls around and says, yung care, share, and dare, tatlong magagandang babae yan. Si Karin, Darin, at si Sharin. But what does he really mean by that? Unless Filipinos care for each other, right now, wala akong pakialam. Attitude na ito. That's it. Unless we care for each other, unless we share our talents, our resources, to help each other grow up the ladder. Right now, that's not happening. The rich are getting richer, the poor are getting poorer. Wala kaming pakialam sa inyo. Yan sa baba. Dare against the odds, dare against the people that prevent us from uniting, that prevent us from sharing and becoming a united nation, to dare to rise up against them. That's what it means, care, share, and dare. Pangatlo has to do with ugali, our ugali. And the only way to get out of our problem, he has three words again. Reform, perform, and transform. Yung reform is wherever we can find opportunities to change the way we do things. Reform. We cannot achieve if we do not perform. And that should be related to teamwork. But the last word is the essence of the spirit of EDSA. Transform. We must transform as a people. We have to change our ugali because it's our good ugali that is holding us back from moving forward. Meaning of that transformation, when people from all walks of life converge in EDSA. Pantay-pantay lahat. Everybody was talking to each other. Everybody was helping out each other. Sorry? Fiesta mood. But yes, it was a fiesta mood because for the first time, people were comfortable with each other. At nagtutulungan. Nagkwentuhan. Walang exclusive. Lahat inclusive. Everybody was included. And that was, to me, the dream. That was the dream that brought me to EDSA. And I saw it unfold before my eyes. Unfortunately, right after that, bumalik na naman ang traditional politics sa atin. At ayaw yung naging matapatak naman. So the challenge to us, today, tomorrow, until we reach the goal, is to focus on unity, solidarity, and teamwork. Care, share, and dare for each other. And to reform, perform, and transform.
Then in the afternoon, you can identify them now. In the museum that the PPC was asked to do. So, mabuhay na, Mr. Camarillo. Mabuhay po tayo lahat ng EDSA.